truly extraordinary, they might as well pick out of the hat.
Wow.
So,
that's
the first step. So, it's more competitive for philosophy than most others, again, because of the low demand.
Low demand, so, like, we gotta get, like, the best people, like...
Exactly. They're only taking the absolute top. So, but it gets worse than that, right? So that's just getting into the PhD. Let's say you finish your PhD, good dissertation, you do well, blah, blah, blah. Let's say you go to NYU. You now have 7 other people in your PhD, in your dissertation here, who also did really well, right? Like, no one's going to do poorly if you can get into NYU.
Right, you're really good at that.
So you have 8 equally qualified candidates who all went to the same quality school, plus, you know, Harvard, Yale, Stanford, so all the other, like, top 10 schools. So you have roughly 75 to 90 people competing for, we're all roughly equally qualified, competing for maybe 2 or 3 jobs.
Two or three.
Yeah, out for them.
Out of 90 people.
Let me rephrase. Tenure track jobs.
Okay.
So non-adjunct positions. And you'll also be competing against people.
This is a hand warmer, by the way.
Are taking.
All right, so we got Steve as. Yeah,
so they're already professors. And they want to get a better.
Two people who have a decent shot at getting really far.
Let's say
this,
I'll give us. We'll be generous. 5 tenure track positions for.
Yeah.
Let's say the
this is just hand warmer. I think I just said
plus
that.
Plus people looking to move up in the field. And that's 5 jobs. That's 5 jobs.
It seems like Steve's Blue Fox and Bats.
They all got a 3-9 major, they all got a
really top B class.
Yeah, they're all indistinguishable from each other in a lot of ways.
5 jobs.
Yeah. And for tenure track. On top of that, get into tenure track jobs, only about a quarter of the time actually land tenure. So you have to.
It's like almost 1 out of 5.
Yeah, so 1 out of those 5 people will actually land a tenure track job. So you have to get into a top 25 PhD school, which again, you know, 2 to 5% acceptance rates. Then you have to really stand out among your class and field. So, and then you have to. Once you land a job, you might as well just like roll the dice on a 1 in 4 of getting landing the tenure.
Well, Mark says to watch an indie movie. To go watch an indie movie.
Well, it sounds pretty good. Like, the prospects aren't sounding too great.
Oh, they're terrible. The odds are terrible. You only do it because you love it and you don't want to do anything
else. I guess I was naive. I feel like everyone did.
You'll get your PhD, but that doesn't mean you'll get a job.
And so, like, you have it, but, like, no one's hiring you.
Yeah, exactly. Wow. There is no point in getting a philosophy PhD except to teach.
So, like, you need to, like,
get... All right, so let's get it started.
You might as well have not gotten the PhD if you decide not to get a philosophy PhD. So...
That was an interesting affair for the platform.
Like economics, right? You get a PhD in economics, the average person is making like $85,000.
Baz really plays a lot of characters. I was expecting him to go Fox here, honestly.
Yeah, you get a PhD in econ, you're like guaranteed probably like a low, mid, 6-figure job.
That's kind of weird how he didn't do anything after that. You expect like a grab or a shine or something.
I'm taking a gap year, so I'm going to apply in 2019.
So, like, the type of year you're off.
Nice
platform cancel though.
Yeah, that's the best case scenario. Yeah, more likely I'll probably go into
try to do
civil rights which are more pragmatic.
I mean, like, honestly, well, like, they're really smart. Like,
yeah, that's true.
Here's the problem though. Take me, multiply me by 50, and you like overall. Yeah. So, like, even if I'm, let's say...
If you're, like, crossing above people here, like, everyone else.
Exactly. Let's say I'm, like, you know, top 2.
I just wanted to let you know, like, I was playing the game, and I just heard you talk about the last game, and I'm like, oh, shit. Definitely helped me win.
Glad to hear. So, like,
Well, that up tilt was really nice, even though he missed the tech chase.
Yeah, I would be an outstanding.
I tried to bait out the dash attack, but kind of misspaced his dash.
Even if I'm a great student.
Looks pretty even.
That's still 5%.
Oh, wow. Yeah, there are little moments like that where they both kind of hesitate.
That is directly competing with me for that few numbers. Oh, it's brutal. Most of my professors.
Yeah, stuff like this.
In general, like
a little bit of a lag there that someone might be able to.
They are shy to tell you if they don't think you're ready.
Oh, there it takes it though.
Yeah. Well, not again. A lot of
wait, NASA Halberd, wait to play because you'll be on stage.
It's not good enough.
Exactly.
Yeah, next.
So, like, the fact that my thesis advisor said that he thinks I would, like, make a good grad student, it meant a lot. Because, like, again, they're not just going to throw that around because, like,
it's so bad for you.
Yeah, exactly. And to some degree, there's survivorship bias among the professors because they're the ones who, like, landed other jobs.
It's like, they like, actually.
Yeah, exactly. So, like, all those philosophy professors, like, you don't see all the people who didn't make it, you only see the people who did, and the job looks fucking amazing.
I mean, like, you don't have to joke about, like, how about, like, philosophy, you can't get a job like this.
The thing that makes me laugh about it is philosophy is consistently the best for all students.
Like, it's one of the best majors.
Yeah, if you specifically want to go to law school, you, like, philosophy, gov, or, like, you can't do better. But, like, if you want, like, a...
Just pure philosophy.
Yeah.
Oh, hey, Chris, how's it going?
Like, that's when, like... That's when your head's in the clouds a little bit.
I didn't know it was like that bad.
Professor from who's at Boulder right now. He had a page. UC Boulder. He has stats on his experiences. Michael, he's a great philosopher.
We're both looking a little bit shaky.
So if you're very modern posture, are you dropping hot takes?
Honestly, it's kind of the opposite. Like, philosophy, the way logic has changed the field of philosophy, like formal reverse logic, your arguments have to be tighter and tighter, which means your claims have to be slightly less bold than they used to be.
So it's hard to, like, argue against your claims. Your claims aren't, like, huge, but it's, like,
really hard. Right, John, you play, you play Brady and Luther.
Wow. It goes on to less refutable, right? Yeah.
So this, like, list.
Well, where are we looking at? Like, what can I do with the philosophy?
Yeah, so this is all stuff. He's had a couple of books that sold really well.
Reed, what was the score? 200.
This is like a picture.
Yeah, well, let me scroll down. What the fuck is this? Whatever. Basically, he's just saying what I said, but from, like, a little personal perspective.
Yeah.
He gives a... he went to Rutgers, which is actually an outstanding PhD program. It's kind of funny. Like, you wouldn't expect But Rutgers is, like top five or top three.
Top five?
Yeah.
So among the five this year?
Yeah. Wow. They're just as good as, like...
Why?
I don't know. They just happen to develop the culture there.
Yeah.
I don't know. But, like, Huber went to Rutgers. He was the top. He got the award for best dissertation in his class at Rutgers. He applied to 30 schools. He heard back from
Fuga is just not commentating anymore.
Yeah. Jackson asked me about PHPs.
Wait, so one out of
all right, everyone. Welcome to Arcadian Singles. Here we have Steve versus Baz. Baz. Boz is a, he's been to a few tournaments.
It seems like he comes every now and then for like the more important stuff.
He had a few good wins. He impressive performance at last year's Arcadian, which was much more stacked than this one, as far as I know. Ooh, unfortunate for Steve.
Looking like we're going to have game three.
Yeah, that's what. So okay, good combo. I do think,
that was a nice up tilt.
Oh, he should have just... Oh, go down there! Okay, whatever. He's still probably...
I don't like that as special.
Best case scenario...
Neither of them. You just have to go down there.
Yeah.
Okay, so... So he should clutch this out, but now he could get gimped. Yeah,
there
good
we
is.
Go.
Yeah.
I'll be 30,
So it is.
So, let's see.
1-1.
I'm going to be 22 at the end of this year.
Yeah.
I will apply in 2019 for grad school in 2020. So I will start again in college.
It's
5 years.
Alright.
It's 5 years.
Yeah, so Steve Cannon picks FOD.
Yeah.
I guess to stop Blazers. I don't know, I didn't watch.
Well, it's
game
basically like basically
one or most of game two. Ooh, okay,
so,
he's got Steve in the corner.
And then,
nice tech chase. That was probably supposed to be an up tilt.
Yeah. An up smash works too. Oh,
wow.
Alright. Yeah, up smash's hitboxes are really.
I could be a
maybe Steve needs to slow it down.
Don't play so free.
Yeah. You can really. Slow a Falco down just by cool hopping in center stage, honestly. Using the top platform. Ooh, bad dash attack, but I don't know if Boz knows how to shine out of field. So.
Oh, that jump was not good. But he made it back anyway. Oh, that was a bad
ooh, good lasers. Oh, okay, that was nice. It was, the door was a little late.
I didn't expect it, honestly.
Okay.
Oh
man, what's the word? He's putting the pressure on Steve for sure. Okay. Good. Ooh, right in. Okay. Ooh, nice. That was good. Kind of, I guess it could have lost to the Derva, which would have been bad. Ooh.
Wow, this is. I didn't expect this.
This is pretty dominant.
Your phone is playing the stream.
Yes.
Oh yeah, you're right.
It's on the phone. Who is the viewer? Yeah, we should all get on our phone. I don't have the battery life.
Oh my god. That was nice. Steve makes this
major requirement. That
would be impressive. Is this best of 3 or 5?
This is 3. Next round is best of 5.
Okay.
So next semester,
oh, wow.
I will be taking
big upset.
3 classes.